On July 8th, we did our pilgrimage in a novel way. 15 of us, friends and friends' friends, all devotees of Sri Ramakrishna, started out from Dakshineshwar by a boat in the morning to make a tour of the places of pilgrimage along the bank of Ganga, which was sanctified by Sri Ramakrishna's visit. On our way, we saw quite a few temples on the bank of the Ganga. This is the headquarter of Sarada Math. Our first stop was Kamarhati, Gopaler Ma's sadhana sthal. Kamarhati is only 2 or 3 miles from Dakshineshwar. First, we saw Radha Govinda temple. This temple garden on the bank of the Ganga belongs to Govinda Chandra Datta. He installed the holy images of Radha and Krishna with great pomp. It seems the entire area became red as thousands of monks attended the inaugural celebrations of the temple. Sri Ramakrishna came here later and expressed great joy to see the service of the holy images. On that occasion, he sang songs before the images there. Seeing his wonderful ecstasy at the time of singing, all were greatly charmed. Gopaler Ma used to stay in this complex. She used to spend her time in the service of the images in the temple. Her room was in the extreme south of the garden. One could have a good view of the Ganga through the 3 southern windows of the room. She sat in that room, watched the Ganga flow by, and performed japa night and day. Thus, it was here that one early morning, Gopaler Ma had the vision of Sri Ramakrishna as her chosen deity Gopala. She saw that Sri Ramakrishna was sitting near her to the left, and the palm of his right hand looked half clenched. He was enjoying her astonishment. Then, as soon as she caught hold of his left hand, Ramakrishna vanished into the void, and a 10-month-old real Gopala came out of that figure. And oh, the beauty of it! Gopaler Ma was overwhelmed. Now, we are on to our next destination. Before reaching each place of pilgrimage, one of us read out descriptions of the place and others listened intently so that we were well aware of the glory of the places in advance. This is Panihati of the annual Danda Mahotsav fame. Every year for the last 400 years, thousands of people attend this pilgrimage center to take Harinama. On the bank of the Ganga is the banyan tree, which is 700 years old. It is witness to the arrival of both Sri Chaitanya and Sri Ramakrishna. The shrine at the center of the annual festival, known as Mahotsav Tala, is near this banyan tree. Beside it is Gauranga Ghat. Both Sri Chaitanya and Sri Ramakrishna landed here when they visited Panihati. The story behind this Dando Mahotsav, or festival as punishment, is that Raghunath Das was blessed with a punishment for secretly enjoying the bliss of the Lord's grace. The danda, or punishment, was that Raghunath was to feed the large number of Vaishnavas chira, or flattened rice with milk, curd, etc., which he carried out gladly year after year. This festival is continuing even now, and Sri Ramakrishna used to attend this festival for many years. Sri Ramakrishna's presence created a tremendous devotional fervor every year. The devotees used to feel that Sri Chaitanya himself was being manifested in the person of Sri Ramakrishna. His divine intoxication was contagious, and thousands felt the ecstasy. Panihati is also associated with Raghav Pandit, a foremost disciple of Sri Chaitanya. At the shrine of Raghav's house, we can see the image of Madan Mohan, which was worshipped by Raghav himself. We also see Radharaman and the images of Sri Chaitanya and Prabhu Nityananda. Sri Chaitanya's Pada Padma is worshipped even now. This is Raghav Pandit's home, known as Patbari. At one corner is Madhavi Kunja, where Raghav Pandit used to take classes. His Samadhi Memorial is here. This is a museum of his relics. It contains replica of things used by him. Raghav Jhali gets the pride of place. These are the replica of food items Raghav used to carry on his annual visits to Puri during Ratha Yatra. Monishen of Panihati was Ramakrishna's patron after Mathur Babu. He too belonged to this place. Sri Ramakrishna used to take rest in his home while in Panihati. Radha and Krishna of Monishen's time are still worshipped in his shrine. Gauranga and Nityananda are at the center. Other deities are Jagannath, Balaram, Subhadra, Mangal Chandi and Narayan Shila. While attending the Panihati festival, Sri Ramakrishna would pass through all these places, singing and dancing, and thousands of ecstatic devotees following him, dancing in huge circles around him. This is the courtyard of Monishen's house, where Sri Ramakrishna danced. Saradanandaji describes the sequence thus. Dancing under the influence of spiritual emotions, he was now proceeding, now receding, with a rapid step to the beat of the kirtan. He seemed like a fish swimming in the Satchidananda ocean in great delight. He was wearing an ochre cloth that blended with his skin. And as he danced in ecstasy, he seemed to be surrounded by flames of fire. It seemed Sri Chaitanya had appeared again. His face, beaming with peace, bliss and compassion, spread a wonderful light which illumined all sides. On our way to our next destination, we saw some temples on the bank. Then proceeded to Khardah. Sri Ramakrishna's visit to the famous Shyam Sundar temple here added a fresh dimension to the devotional ambience of the place. Here, our boat was unable to take us to the bank because of low tide. The boatman asked us to trade a narrow path through the Ganga. One step here and there at either side would result in fall in the water. So, we walked cautiously through the water in the Ganga to reach the bank. It was real fun. We remembered Totapuri's walk through the Ganga, where the river was so shallow that he could not drown himself. Probably, Divine Mother made him take the route like ours. Sri Chaitanya too is associated with the glory of this place. His disciple Prabhu Nityananda is the main inspiration behind the holiness of this place. Nityananda's son Virbhadra installed their family deity Shyam Sundar here. Although the temple is centuries old and has lost much of its original decoration with the passage of time, it is still very graceful. Shyam Sundar and Radhika are placed on a silver throne. The Nat Mandir too is quite spacious. Sri Ramakrishna visited this place by a boat and walked to the temple. As soon as he reached the temple, he went into Samadhi. Devotees present there were filled with delight as they felt the presence of Sri Chaitanya within Sri Ramakrishna. Sri Ramakrishna gazed at the deity attentively. Then he commented, "Ma, you are playing the flute here?" He saw the Divine Mother in the Shyam Sundar idol. And he again went into deep Samadhi. Later, it came to be known that Shyam Sundar is worshipped as Kali at a certain time of the year. Till now, the devotees consider Shyam Sundar, Sri Chaitanya and Sri Ramakrishna as one. We had lunch prasad of Shyam Sundar, the same one that Sri Ramakrishna too had, and commented later to his disciples, "When I go to Khardah to visit Shyam Sundar, the father entertains me with sacred offerings such as one cannot buy even for 100 rupees. We also saw Nityananda's house. It is amazing how even after hundreds of years, these places are maintained as they were. Khardah still retains the old world charm and takes us back centuries. Next, we came to the other side of Ganga and visited Sri Rampur Radhavallabh temple. Although it was afternoon temple closure time, here we could see Jagannath as he does not take his midday nap. Then we went to the adjacent locality called Mahesh, which hosts the second largest Jagannath Ratha festival. The first is Puri. By participating in the Ratha Jatra here, Sri Chaitanya and Sri Ramakrishna greatly glorified the festival. Thousands of devotees attend this festival here every year. Before his devotees came, Sri Ramakrishna used to attend this festival in Mahesh. As in Panihati, his total absorption in divine bliss created a stir in the hearts of the general public. His last participation with his disciples in the festival here is especially memorable. That was Jagannath Deva's Ultarath. Though Sri Ramakrishna was ill, the attraction to join the festival was so strong in him that he came here by boat with his disciples like Gopaler Ma and Latu. He ran like an arrow to join the crowd and became immersed in Mahabhava. His face was radiant with indescribable beauty. He stood dangerously just in front of the moving chariot. Because of the milling crowd, his terrified disciples could not go near him to rescue him. Suddenly, 50 hefty men left the rope and surrounded Sri Ramakrishna, forming a protective hem. They shouted, "Look, the gracious Thakur is here." When the chariot stopped, people started inquiring about the reason. Sri Ramakrishna rushing madly to have a glimpse of him. All the while, Sri Ramakrishna stood there, completely self-absorbed and beaming radiantly. To have a sight of Sri Ramakrishna was to have a vision of Lord Jagannath. In this spot was a three-storied house where Sri Ramakrishna took rest. The house is no more, but a Tulsi Mancha has been erected here to commemorate the occasion. Here, not only Sri Ramakrishna, but also Gopaler Ma became ecstatic. We took our boat from Jagannath Ghat and proceeded to Chanak or Barakpur. It is famous for the Annapurna temple on the bank of the Ganga. This temple was constructed by Mathur's wife Jagadamba as a replica of Dakshineshwar temple. Sri Ramakrishna attended the inauguration function. The arrangements of the temples here are the same as in Dakshineshwar, but they are smaller than the original ones. And this complex houses 6 Shiva temples. Here too, Thakur's rest room is there at one corner, which is used now as meditation room. Lastly, on our way back, we sang Ramakrishna Sharanam and ended the magnificent 10-hour trip. We are reminded of Ames saying, "These places are sanctified by Sri Ramakrishna's holy footsteps. One will achieve everything merely by visiting these places." Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa.